In today's video, I'm going to tell you why do women get hyper or hypothyroidism, which means high or low thyroid levels after delivery, and what can you expect from it, and most importantly, what can you do about it. And if you stick around to the end, I'll tell you what is the difference between postpartum thyroiditis and Hashimoto's thyroiditis. Welcome to another episode of Dr. Says. First up, postpartum thyroiditis means inflammation of your thyroid gland after delivery of the baby. Like Graves, it is an autoimmune process, and this causes destruction of your thyroid gland. It usually occurs within 1 year after delivery and can present in one of three ways. First, transient hyperthyroidism alone. Second, transient hypothyroidism alone. Or third, a transient hyperthyroidism followed by hypothyroidism and then recovery. Here is what you can expect. About 20-30% of women will experience hyperthyroidism 1-4 months after delivery, which lasts around 2-8 weeks, followed by hypothyroidism, which lasts from 2 weeks to 6 months, and then recovery. The symptoms and signs of hyperthyroidism when present are typically mild and consist mainly of fatigue, weight loss, palpitations, heat intolerance, anxiety, and tremor. Similarly, hypothyroidism is also usually mild, leading to lack of energy, cold intolerance, constipation, sluggishness, and dry skin. To confirm the diagnosis, your doctor will measure your blood T4 and T3 levels as well as TSH levels. For patients presenting with hyperthyroidism, further evaluation will be needed to make sure it is not Graves' disease. If you missed out on my previous video where I talk about Graves' disease, link will be in the top right corner. Now, can it be treated? Well, if one is in the hyperthyroid phase, most patients do not require any treatment. Beta blockers may be useful to relieve bothersome palpitations or tremulousness in symptomatic patients. There is no role for antithyroid drugs in the treatment of the hyperthyroid phase of postpartum thyroiditis. Instead, thyroid tests should be repeated in 48 weeks to confirm the resolution of hyperthyroidism. However, if one is in a hypothyroid state, if symptomatic with an elevated TSH levels above the normal range, one will require treatment with levothyroxine. For those without symptoms, treatment is also warranted if your TSH levels are more than 10 milliunit per liter. Most patients with hypothyroidism will have recovery within 6 to 12 months. Sadly, up to 30% of individuals never recover from the initial hypothyroid phase and may require lifelong replacement with levothyroxine. And the risk factor are high titers of antithyroid peroxidase antibodies and the severity of the initial hypothyroid phase. The more severe the hypothyroid, the higher chance of a permanent hypothyroidism.
Oh no!
Now, thank you for sticking around, so it's time to answer the question, what's the difference between postpartum thyroiditis and Hashimoto's thyroiditis? For starters, both are autoimmune processes and involve the destruction of the thyroid gland. However, for postpartum thyroiditis, the effect is usually transient and reversible, while for Hashimoto's, it is chronic and usually not reversible. The treatment for postpartum thyroiditis is a maximum of 1 year, while lifelong replacement of thyroxine is usually required for Hashimoto's. And finally, thyroid antibodies are almost always present in Hashimoto's, while not always the case for postpartum thyroiditis. So there you have it, guys. Now you know what's the difference between postpartum thyroiditis and Hashimoto's. Do you want to know what's the difference between gestational thyrotoxicosis and Graves? Click the link on the screen to find out.